Hallelujah.
I worship you.
Amen. Hallelujah. This is Choice Radio. Amen. I am Reverend Dr. Jimmy Baptiste.
And I'm Reverend Dr. Sandra Baptiste.
Hallelujah. And we welcome you once again to Life in Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We thank you for tuning into this broadcast once again. Amen. And as usual, we're going to begin in prayer. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Father, we just want to give you praise and we want to give you thanks, Lord, for your goodness, your mercy, your grace upon our lives. Lord, we thank you, God, for your favor, Lord, which is better than life, as your word says. We thank you, God, for all the people who are listening even right now. We bless your name, Lord, for the air that has been inclined and the hearts who are tuned right now, Lord, to your word and is ready to receive. Father, let your spirit, O God, speak through us. Lord, let your anointing power flow through the airwaves, O God, of Choice Radio tonight. And that somebody, O God, will be delivered, O God. That somebody will be healed, somebody will be blessed, and somebody will be saved. In the mighty name of Jesus. So, Lord, we say thank you in advance for doing it. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Once again, this is Life in Jesus. And we want to thank the saints for listening and supporting Choice Radio and supporting our program, Life in Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And tonight we're going to discuss a topic that is important to the saints' knowledge and understanding. And we're going to be discussing tonight God's evaluation of you.
Amen.
Amen. Or if you want to put it another way, we're going to be discussing your worth according to God.
That's right.
What are we worth to God? Amen.
Amen.
So God's evaluation of you. Hallelujah. And we're going to begin, amen, with Genesis 1 and 28. Because this topic we will come to see and understand, amen, and get a better understanding of who we are in Christ and how God sees us. Hallelujah. And not only us in Christ, but how God sees mankind on the whole.
Amen.
On the whole, sorry, meaning believer and unbeliever, or saved and unsaved. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we're going to begin with by reading Genesis 1 and 28.
Amen. And as usual, the phone lines will be open about 20 minutes to the hour. Amen. So if we could follow, and when you do call in, that you could help us by giving your input. Amen. So that we could be ministered to and learn something, because we believe that everybody have something to teach each other. Amen.
Amen.
And as we read to your listening ears, Genesis 1:28, and it says, "And God blessed them and said unto them, Be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth."
Amen. But that's Genesis 1:28.
Amen.
But I want the listener to focus on part B of that verse that says, "Have dominion over the fish of the sea."
Yes.
"Over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth.
Amen.
Amen. So we see here at the beginning of creation that God gave man dominion over every other living thing.
Amen.
That he himself created.
Yes.
So this, pardon, this speaks directly into, hallelujah, the exalted position that man enjoyed from the beginning of creation.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We will look at Genesis 2 and 15.
Genesis 2:15 says, "And the Lord God took the man and put him into the garden of Eden to dress it and to keep it."
Amen. So now, in the first instance, in Genesis 1 and 28, man is exalted above all living thing that is created because God gave him dominion.
Yes.
Amen. So he has an exalted position. In this second instance, man is made responsible for all creation. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So now we're dealing with God's evaluation of you.
Amen.
So he first exalts man over every living thing.
Yes.
And then he made him responsible.
Yes.
To care for them. Amen.
Yes.
And to make sure that he upkeep their welfare.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Genesis 2 and 7, and at any time, as usual, you could chime in. Genesis 2 and 7.
Genesis 2 and 7, and it says, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul."
Okay, we're starting to get somewhere now.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're dealing with your God's evaluation of man, or God's evaluation of you. We have to make it personal.
Yes.
Amen. And in this chapter, in this verse here, Genesis 2 and 7, it says that God breathed into the nostril of man.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Then man became a living soul.
Yes.
So this plainly tells us that God put his own breath.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yes.
In man.
Hallelujah.
Mind you, the breath of God, amen, is connected to his words.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So we must remember that he created everything by speaking.
Yes.
But when he fashioned man, he did it with his hands.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
So instead of speaking man into existence, he himself labored over man.
Yes, amen.
And the words that he spoke, amen, is his very breath.
Hallelujah.
But instead of speaking, we would say that he breathed into man.
Yes.
And now man became a living soul. So what animated man and caused him to come alive is the very breath of God.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. So we starting to get an idea of our value.
Mm-hmm.
Of God's evaluation of you.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to look at 1 Thessalonians 5 and 23. And we would like you to take a note of the scripture and go over them for yourself, compare them to what we say, examine them. Amen. and you are free to agree or disagree and come to your own conclusion. Amen. This is how we learn.
Amen.
1 Thessalonians 5 and 23.
And it reads, "And the very God of peace sanctify you wholly." "And I pray God, your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ."
Okay.
Amen.
So you wanna chime in?
No, go ahead. I'll chip in.
So what I want to draw attention to is the breakdown or the description of man's design. What it says there? May he sanctify you what?
Holy.
W-H-O-L-L-Y. Right. In which parts?
Holy. Your whole man. Your whole body. Sanctify you holy, spirit, soul, and body.
Amen. So this is one of the scripture that plainly shows, amen, how God created man. Because what it shows here is God created us just as himself.
Amen. Amen.
Because man... Hallelujah. Let me not get ahead of myself. So it says spirit, soul, and body. So God created us just as he is. Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. We go back to Genesis 1, 26 to 27. Genesis 1, 26 to 27.
Okay, and it says, "And God said, let us make man in our image after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every living thing that creep upon the earth."
Okay, so now, Genesis 1, 26 and 27 is repeating... Amen. Or
yes.
He first consults with Jesus and the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And they agree on what they're going to do concerning the creation of man. And we see in 28 that man is created.
27.
Right. But in Genesis 1 and 28, after man is created,
he blessed them.
Right, and he gave them dominion.
Yes.
But when they first consulted among themselves,
verse 26,
concerning man,
in
Genesis 1, 26 and 28, he gave a description, or they came to an agreement of how they're going to design man. And he says, then God said, let us, he's speaking to the two that will make up the Trinity with him, make man in our image, according to our likeness. Okay? So this image and this likeness, amen? Remember in 1 Thessalonians before, it speak about, may he sanctify you wholly, body, soul, and spirit.
Yes.
Amen. So now, they're discussing in Genesis 1 and 26, how they're going to design man. Are we going to make him corporeal, or are we going to make him tripartite? They decided, no, we're going to make him in our image and our likeness.
Yes.
So for you to have his image and his likeness, you must have three parts, as he is a Trinity, yet united.
Yes.
The Hebrew word is echad, meaning the united one.
Yes.
Amen. So when man is created now, he has a body, amen, that holds the soul, amen, and that is controlled by the spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, because God is triune, he made man tripartite.
Yes.
Amen. So now he does that so that we can be in his image and his likeness.
Mm-hmm.
His image is an express copy or an exact replica of how he looks.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
For lack of a better word, I have to say of how he looks physically.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Because Amen. Because God is spirit.
Yes.
But for this teaching, to get understanding, he is an exact copy.
Mm-hmm.
An exact copy of him.
Yes. Of
That's
him.
His image.
Yes.
But his likeness deals with his characteristics.
Yes.
How he behaves, how he thinks, and how he operates.
Yes.
Amen. So now he has made man in his image and likeness. That is why he was able to have confidence now to give Adam dominion.
Yes.
Over the other living things.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because Adam was able to think like him,
mm-hmm.
act like him,
mm-hmm.
and operate just as he would operate.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen.
So when Adam walked about, amen, it was an exact copy or replica of God on earth doing the things that he would do,
mm-hmm.
having dominion,
yes,
and taking care
mm-hmm.
of all the other created beings.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And we will see, as we go on, if time permit, amen, we will see the responsibility that Adam gave, that Adam got from God, and why, amen,
mm-hmm.
as I just explained, because he has now God's image and likeness.
Amen.
Amen. Pardon me. Psalms 8, verses 4-8. Hallelujah. We're discussing God's evaluation of you, or your worth according to God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And if you're just tuning in, this is Life in Jesus. You must understand who you are in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
What are we worth? Amen. Psalms 8:4-8.
And it reads,
mm-hmm.
What is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him?
Uh-huh.
For you has made him a little lower than the angels.
Yes.
And has crowned him with glory and honor.
Uh-huh.
You made him to have dominion over the works of your hands, and has put all things under his feet.
Amen.
All sheep and oxen, yea, and the beasts of the field, the fowl of the air, and the fish of the sea,
uh-huh.
and whatsoever passeth through the paths of the sea.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, if you look at verse 4, and 5 again. What does it say?
It says, what is man?
Mm-hmm.
That thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him.
Yes.
For you have made him a little lower than the angels.
Amen.
And has crowned him with glory and honor.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now, what Psalms is, David actually is rehearsing here. Hallelujah, is what took place
mm-hmm. before
in Genesis.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Amen. But you see, in this scripture, you must understand that he's asking the question, amen, from a mindset of trying to understand why God has honored us so much,
mm-hmm.
and it says here that you have made him a little lower than the angels. But you see, this is a weak translation in English, because from the original Hebrew text, the word that is inserted in this translation angels. Actually, in the Hebrew text that this verse is taken from, it says Elohim, meaning God. You have made him a little lower than God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And you have crowned him with glory and honor. You have made him to have dominion over the works of your hands. That is exactly what took place in Genesis.
Yes.
So, what this text is saying is that we are actually created under the class, in the class that is actually right under God.
Amen.
That means we are created higher than the angels. And as saints and as Christians, we must understand that our purpose, amen, for being saved and reconciled back to God, amen, is that our original the original intent that God had for us and had for Adam must be fulfilled.
Must be, yes.
Because what God intended for Adam, nothing can derail it.
Amen.
Not even the devil or sin. That is why he sent his son Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And we will get into the coming of Jesus Christ in this discussion to even show you more worth that you have. Amen.
Amen.
So it shows here that man is actually a class of spirit. If you look at the Greek rendering or the Greek word that it is translated in English, the word man speaks of a class of spirit, because God is a spirit.
Yes.
And so Psalms here tells you that we are created right under the class of the godly spirit of God, who is spirit. So man is directly under God. And the angels, amen, and then all the other living things. The reason why he didn't say to have dominion over the angels, because remember the angels are in heaven.
Yes.
But he says on all the living things on the earth. It's not that God, man is not higher than the angel. It's just that the angels are in heaven. They are more powerful than us in energy. Because one angel can destroy 185,000 people. In the Old Testament, one of them destroyed a city consisting of 185,000 people.
Yes.
So they were created to serve us and to work with us as we work in faith with Jesus Christ.
Yes.
So when we decree certain things, they act on what we speak.
Yes.
Amen. So we are higher than them in purpose.
Yes.
But they are more powerful than us. Amen. Hallelujah. When it comes to warfare.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
In the sense of actual energy.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
But because we have a higher purpose, they serve us.
Yes.
God has ordained it that they serve us. Amen. And protect us. So, hallelujah.
Amen.
We're discussing God's evaluation of you. And this discussion is not reserved only for the saved person. This are God's evaluation of man on the whole, whether sinner or saint. We all have the same value.
Yes.
And
God, yes.
To God.
Yes.
Whether we're saved or not. Amen. So look at John 3:16.
Well, we all know that scripture.
Everybody knows that scripture.
John 3:16.
Amen.
Let me find it so I don't misquote it.
For God so loved the world.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
John 3:16. For God so loved the world.
Yes.
That he gave his only begotten son. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
All right. So, two things there. He says that he inserted the word, the world. So that means the sinner.
Yeah.
He so loved the world that Okay, so he so loved the sinners.
Yes.
That he sent his only begotten Holy Son, unblemished, faultless and sinless, that whoever believes on him shall be saved. That includes me and you.
Amen.
Because at a point in our life, we were unbelievers.
Yes, yes.
Because there's a scripture that says, when we were without strength, God sent his Son to die for us. Meaning when we were lost in sin.
Amen.
We were without strength, lost in sin. He died for us.
Yes.
So God's evaluation and this program shows that God values sinner and saint the same way.
The same way, yes.
Equally.
Equally. Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So John 3:16 shows that God deemed it worthy to send his Son to die for us.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Luke 15:7. And as we said before, we need you to write the scriptures, go over them, meditate on them. Amen. Let them come alive in your spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Because there is nothing more important than knowing who you are and knowing whose you are and also knowing what you are worth. Amen.
Amen.
To God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it reads, Luke 15:7, I say unto you, that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repented, more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance.
Amen. You want to say something?
Listen, you know, we have kind of these days you haven't really been hearing about people getting saved.
Okay.
And somehow the message of salvation is designated to the end of the program.
Amen.
We come and we talk about everything else. We forget that souls need to be saved. We say it, but most of the times it's dedicated to the end of the program, where we would say, if anybody doesn't know the Lord,
yes,
now is the time to get to know him, you know. But we really should come back to the drawing board, where our main focus should be about the saving of the souls.
Hallelujah.
Because in this scripture, he say, Jesus was speaking and he say that likewise, he said joy should be in heaven.
Over who?
Over one sinner.
Amen.
And if we read up before that, he was talking about other things where it will be joy, but it wasn't about the soul.
Yes.
And the joy in the prior comments that he was making pertaining to the examples. The joy he was talking about, it wasn't a rejoicing that would have resonated in heaven.
Hallelujah.
But this joy where a sinner got saved.
Amen.
It was recorded in heaven. So it's telling me that because God overwhelmingly, because God without any reservations cared about us.
Yes.
He decided to send himself.
Hallelujah.
To his Son Jesus.
Amen.
To walk just to save one sinner.
Hallelujah.
So we thank God that heaven rejoices once when one sinner repents.
Amen. And if you look at we will look at the same scripture in Matthew. Hallelujah. Caller, you're on the air.
Good night, Doctor.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
Two things I'm looking at, you know. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 talk about Jesus came to reconcile man back to God. So that also is included with what you are saying there. That, you know, man, the church supposed to be looking first at the saving of souls. And the thing is, with that scripture there, that chapter there, he said he left a ministry. So that ministry was to put in place so that the evangelism would have been more effective.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Another thing I'm looking at is when you talked just now about John 3:16, and we know everybody know it, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But something that's puzzled me there when it says whosoever.
Mm-hmm.
Whosoever.
Uh-huh.
Believe. And for years, you know, sometimes people asking you questions and you're based on that whosoever. I just say to people, whosoever, be it you, me, whoever,
mm-hmm.
that would believe in Jesus Christ. So when you said just now about the unsaved and the saved,
yes.
that whosoever, people are supposed to understand that quite clear.
Mm-hmm.
That the whosoever is who, you, whether you're saved or you're unsaved, whoever would come and believe in him, will not perish but would have everlasting life. And that is a good evangelism chapter there to, you know, verse there to tell people.
Amen.
Whosoever.
Yes.
So you are not left out because it's whosoever.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I just want to, you know, make my input there on that part.
Amen. Amen. Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
We thank God for that comment. Amen.
Hallelujah. And yes, because that word whosoever, it is tied to that he sent the whole world. He came for the whole world.
For the whole world.
Because with God, he left it open to everybody.
Everybody, yes.
Whosoever. He left it up to you because he doesn't exclude anybody.
Nobody.
He includes the whole world.
Yes.
That is why he said, whosoever.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
The choice is yours.
Yes.
It's your life, your salvation. Your choice.
Amen.
Is whosoever.
Whosoever.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That means the whole world.
The whole world. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. And we thank you for that call. It goes straight into our topic, God's evaluation of you, or what are you worth to God?
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. So in this Luke 15 and 7, what I wanted to say is that we will look at the same incident in Matthew.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Because he's speaking about the sinner, as we said.
Mm-hmm.
The sinner and the saint has the same value.
Yes, to God.
To God. The difference with the sinner is that he is not fulfilling his purpose according to God's will.
Yes.
As yet.
Right. As yet.
Whereas the saint is.
Mm-hmm.
But they both have the same value to God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
So
that is why the Bible says that the heaven rejoices over one sinner who becomes a saint.
Amen. Amen.
Who gives his life to the Lord.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yes.
And okay, let's look at Matthew 18, the same verse, the same topic. Matthew 18, 10 and 14.
10 and 14, or 10 to 14?
10 to 14.
Okay.
Sorry.
And it says, take heed that you despise not one of these little ones.
Uh-huh.
For I say unto you, that in heaven their angels do always behold the face of my Father,
mm-hmm.
which is in heaven. For the Son of Man is come to save that which was lost.
Uh-huh.
How think ye? If a man have 100 sheep and one of them has gone astray,
uh-huh.
does he not leave the 99 and go into the mountains and seek it that which is gone astray?
Mm-hmm.
And if so be that he find it, verily I say unto you, he rejoiceth more of that sheep
uh-huh.
than of the 99 which went not astray.
Amen.
Even so, it is not the will of your Father
uh-huh.
which is in heaven that one of these little ones should perish.
You want to make any comments?
Listen. let's the
this
natural
the is so beautiful.
Listen, the natural before the spirit. Yeah.
Mm.
We have leaders.
Uh-huh.
And I know some leaders may be listening to me. I'm a leader too. Mm-hmm. Amen. And you might think that I'm beating the leaders over their head. I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just trying to make us more aware of the assignment
yes.
that God has unctioned us to carry out
hey.
In his stead.
Amen.
Listen to me. We have people. We have leaders. We have pastors. Who we have people in the church. and one may stray, and you may not see them, or they may have fallen from grace,
yes,
and they do not take the time to go and look for this one little one who have fallen by the wayside, to bring them back into the fold where the thousands or the hundreds or the fifties are.
Amen.
God will hold us accountable.
Amen.
Because if Jesus could speak it, and he's so concerned about the one that would sway,
yes,
that would stray, that will fall on the wayside, that may have gotten bruised,
yes,
may have gotten lost,
hallelujah,
may have been mixed up with drugs, may have been mixed up with sexual fornication and adulteries.
Go on, man. Hallelujah.
Oh, who may have gotten mixed up with witchcraft.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is saying that you who are the shepherd,
yes,
need to go and look for that one. If you can design and assign people,
amen,
to go look for that one, to bring it back into the fold.
Yes.
Because you see, when you come back into the fold, that's where your healing takes place.
That's right.
Because when the one that was lost realized that I'm looking for them, when they come back, Pastor, they will feel the love of God through us.
Hallelujah.
And what they were doing and what had beset them, they will be strengthened enough, where they will be delivered completely from that which has set them aside from the flock and the fold anyways.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And this goes right into the verse there that he speaks about, the same verse that he speaks about one of these little ones. And he says that their angels in heaven are ever before God. So because we're dealing with your value, God's evaluation of you. And Jesus is telling them, even one of these little children, pardon me, even one of these little children, their angels are ever before God.
You know what ministering to me right now?
Amen.
That Jesus calls us little children, the little ones.
Amen.
It shows that even though you may be up in age, because you had fallen away,
yes,
he sees you as the little one.
Yes.
He sees you as the children, and children need a parent to guide them. Children need somebody to pick them up when they fall down and dust their knees off and get them a good bath and grease them down with some Vaseline and ease the wounds that they endured when they fell.
All right, now look at this. Because I want to keep the topic uppermost.
Hallelujah.
In the listener ear. We're dealing with your value to God.
Yes.
Now in this verse here, Jesus strictly warns them about bringing offense against one of these little ones. Because he's saying now that their angels are ever before God. Now let's look at this. If a cub of a lion or a tiger, amen, is threatened by another animal, you know what will happen to that animal? Much less God himself. Because if a mother and the mothers are in the animal kingdom, when it comes to the kids, the mothers are almost always more dangerous.
Yes.
In protecting the cub.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's look at the human mother. A mother will do anything to protect that little child.
Yes. Yes.
She will dive under a bus, a moving bus, to save the life of that, without no fear.
No fear.
And Jesus is saying, listen, be careful not to offend one of these little ones. There is another part there where he says it's better if that man wasn't born. He talk about taking a millstone and tying it around his neck. Now, if a human mother could do that for a child, and a lioness will go at any length to protect her cub, and God has angels assigned to us and assigned to little children. And the angels are ever before God. That means that God's eye is always upon us. And the angels are there to protect us, and they are reporting to Him.
Amen.
Of our progress.
Yes.
Amen. And He's they're there to protect us.
Mm-hmm.
But check this. This very scripture is tied to the parable of the lost coin, the lost sheep, and the prodigal son.
Yes, yes.
So that's why I'm saying even more, the unsaved person, God is so concerned for them that He gave parables for us to understand, amen, about how much He values us, even when we are sinners.
Mm.
That is why heaven rejoiced over one sinner than 99 just men, meaning 99 men who are already saved. There is more rejoicing over one that just came in.
Yeah.
In heaven.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
We must understand our eternal value to God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. You know, like even further up in the verse where he talks about, except you be converted and become like the little one.
Yes.
So we in the eyes of Jesus, when we are converted and we become in you talked earlier about in the image and likeness.
Yes.
If we, when we are converted and we become in His likeness. Because when you're converted, you're not just in His image, but you become in His likeness.
Amen.
Then He will recognize that here what? You have become, so then you could enter.
Hallelujah.
You have become like the little, so then you could enter.
Amen.
But if we stay lofty and proud, it means even according to what he says here, we're not converted.
No.
So we need to become converted by humbling ourselves as the children do.
Amen.
Amen. Because he's saying if we don't do it, we're not going to enter.
Yes, and you use the word humbling ourselves. The first point of humility is admitting that we need a savior. You see, the reason why people don't come to Christ is because of pride. Because they're proud that I don't need Jesus. But when you understand that, listen, I'm a sinner, and because of sin, I will be condemned.
Yes.
And He's the only one that could get me out of this thing. You have to humble yourself.
Amen.
And when you do humble yourself before the Lord, that's when you're able to accept Him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This is Choice Radio. Hallelujah. It's your life, your salvation, and your choice.
Amen.
It's 347-663-8638, and the phone lines are open. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
So now in Luke 15 and 7, it shows here that God deemed it worthy.
Yes.
That Jesus must die. But even for only one soul.
If it was just for one, he would have come.
In all of eternity. If only one soul had accepted him, God would have deemed it worthy that Jesus should die.
Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And in Matthew 18, amen, as I said, His eyes never leaves His children.
Never, never.
We're so precious to Him.
Amen.
He doesn't take His eyes off of us. Because the Bible says that His eyes go roaming to and fro.
Yes.
Upon the earth.
Amen.
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 Now, Exodus 20 and 5. And I want you to tie the same Exodus 34 and 14 to that. Exodus 20 and 5. Amen.
Amen.
We trust that you are listening and you are understanding the extent of your word. Amen.
Exodus 20 and 5. It says, thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor mm-hmm. serve them. Mm-hmm. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, uh-huh. visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me.
Okay, and tie that to Exodus 34 and 14.
34:14, and it says,
mm-hmm.
For thou shalt worship no other God,
mm-hmm.
for the Lord whose name is jealous is a jealous God.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
So now, it says here plainly,
yes,
that God's name is jealous. Because
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
we in the church, forever we've known only seven of his Jehovistic name.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Jehovah Kana, mm-hmm. Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Nisi, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Jehovah Sitkinu,
mm-hmm.
amen.
Mm-hmm.
He's our healer.
Yeah.
He's our Jehovah Shalom, mm-hmm. God our peace, our healer, our banner,
mm-hmm.
amen.
Yeah.
God our righteousness,
mm-hmm.
And so on.
Mm-hmm.
We've known seven of this Jehovistic name,
mm-hmm.
but there is an eighth one,
mm-hmm.
and we now saw it there.
Yeah, jealous.
He says, my name is jealous.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And the Hebrew rendering is Jehovah Kana.
Mm-hmm.
K-A-N-N-A-H.
Mm-hmm.
Jehovah Kana.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's a jealous God.
Yes.
Now, I heard Oprah saying that she cannot serve this God some years ago, who is Jesus she's speaking about, because she can't understand that if he is God, why would he be jealous of her,
mm-hmm.
who it is claimed that he created her?
Mm-hmm.
So why would the creator be jealous of the creation?
Mm-hmm.
And that is where her theology get mixed up, because she couldn't understand why the Bible would say that God is jealous of who he created.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, when it says that he is a jealous God,
mm-hmm.
amen, he is jealous, amen, to do good for you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He's not jealous, amen, because you were serving other gods. Hallelujah. He's jealous for you to do you good, because he know he's the only one who is able to keep you in perfect peace.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Whereas when we foolishly go after other gods, he know that we will find ourselves in trouble.
Yes.
But he's the only one who could keep us out of trouble, prosper us, and keep us in perfect peace.
Amen.
Amen. And I'll prove that. And this goes into God's evaluation of you.
Mm-hmm.
Because we see the trouble that he has gone through,
mm-hmm.
amen, in first creating us, then bringing us back from the fall of sin,
mm-hmm.
saving us, and then taking care of our welfare,
yes.
eternally.
Yes.
So now, if you look at Jeremiah 29 and 11,
Jeremiah
29 and 11.
The weeping guy.
Amen.
29 and 11, and it says, For I know the thoughts that I have, that I think towards you, says the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Thoughts of peace and mm-hmm. not of evil.
Yes.
To give you an expected end.
To give you an expected end.
Expected end.
So this shows that God is always thinking about you.
Amen. Amen.
Who am I that God?
Mm-hmm.
Almighty God.
Yes.
Okay, let me look at the camera and speak to the listener out there who are looking at the internet right now. Who are you that God should be always thinking about you?
Mm.
The Creator.
Yes.
Almighty God. There is no one higher and loftier than Him.
Mm-hmm.
Yet He's always thinking about you.
Mm-hmm.
It says it here. And he's thinking about you not to do you evil,
mm-hmm.
but to do you good, to keep you in peace,
mm-hmm.
and to give you your expected end.
Mm-hmm.
You know what is your expected end? Your expected end in God's mind is to be with him in eternity.
Yes. Amen.
To rule and reign with him.
Mm-hmm.
So this goes into understanding your value to God.
Amen.
And it goes back to Psalms 8 and 4. What is man?
Mm-hmm.
Amen? That you should visit him.
Mm-hmm.
You have given him dominion over all the works of your hands. He has done that. And yet every second in eternity, not in time, because he exists out of time, and he exists in eternity. Every second in eternity, he's thinking about me.
Yes,
thinking about you.
Yes,
he's thinking about Reverend Dr. Sandra Baptiste.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
He's thinking about Minister Straker and his wife.
Yes.
He's thinking about the listener there who has not given his life to Jesus yet.
Yes.
But you're looking, and tonight I want to tell you, if God is thinking about you even in your unsaved state, imagine when you come to him what he will think about you.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen, amen.
No.
Oh my goodness.
So he's always thinking about you. And I want to say this again. God is not jealous of us as men are jealous of other men because of what they have or what they perceive coming out of envy.
Mm-hmm.
But God is jealous. Amen. He's a jealous God for his creation because he knows no one else can take care of his creations
Amen.
Better than him.
Amen.
That is why he told Israel, listen, don't go after other gods. Don't serve them nor bow down to them. Why?
Amen.
Because they cannot do anything for you.
Nothing, nothing, nothing.
So I am jealous to do you good.
My God.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
It is a holy jealousy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, 2 Corinthians 11 and 2. It speaks directly. Paul is speaking now. And it speaks directly. Amen. Into the jealousy of God that came out of Exodus 25 and Exodus 34:14.
What did you say? 2 Corinthians what?
2 Corinthians 11 and 2. And we have a few more minutes, so we invite someone to call in and give your take, give your input, your opinion. Amen. Say if you're enjoying the program. Hallelujah.
Amen. 2 Corinthians 11 and 2. He said, for I am jealous over you with godly jealousy.
Amen.
For I have espoused you to one husband.
Hallelujah.
That I may present you as a chaste virgin to Christ.
Ay, ay, ay. So Paul here is speaking to the church.
Hallelujah.
So he's jealous with a godly jealousy.
Yes.
So Paul has the mind of Christ. And what he's saying here is that his whole intent is to present us faultless. That is why he preached the way he preached. Amen. He chastised the way he chastised. He corrected, exhorted, built up, amen, edified.
Yes.
The body.
Mm-hmm.
So that when he's finished, the church, who is the bride, pardon me, can be presented to Christ, who is the bridegroom, a chaste virgin.
Imagine that.
Meaning you're pure.
Yes.
So this is the kind of jealousy that he has because he knows that the gospel that he has, amen, comes out of the mind of Christ and the heart of God, where because God has a divine jealousy, Paul also, through Christ, developed that divine jealousy because he knows our work.
Amen.
And now he's saying, I'm doing all this so that I can present you faultless unto Christ.
It just means that when the gospel came to us who were sinners, the word of God was so clean and so rich and so pure that it cleaned us up.
Hallelujah.
And even the natural before the spiritual.
Amen.
When before you knew a man, you were a virgin in your body.
Yes.
Hallelujah. God is saying that he's going to bring you back into that place.
Amen.
Where even, listen, I believe that when he talks about virginity, he even talks about not just the clean tenderness of your heart, but your very body, because you have accepted the word.
Yes.
It has washed you. The blood has cleansed you, and it has brought you back holy. W-H-O-L-L-Y. Holy in every area of your life, so you'll be presented as pure.
Amen.
Pure before Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And this purity goes into your value.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Now, we have a few minutes. We have about 5 more minutes.
We're going to take 5, maybe 10 minutes after the hour.
Amen. About 10 minutes after the hour, so you can have a chance to call in.
Amen.
And say if you're enjoying the program.
Amen.
Matthew 16 and 26. Matthew 16 and 26. Amen. This is Choice Radio. It's your life, your salvation, and it's your choice. The number is 347-663-8638. Amen.
Amen. Matthew
mm-hmm.
16.
Yes.
And 26.
Yes.
For what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul?
Yes.
Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul?
Hallelujah. Mm. So we're getting down to it now. Mm. Jesus is plainly saying here, if you gain the whole world in exchange for your soul, you have lost.
Yes. Yes.
You have been cheated. Mm. Amen.
Amen.
Because he goes on in the second part of the verse and he asks, what can a man give,
mm-hmm.
amen, for his soul?
Mm.
So in the first instance, he said, even if you sold your soul for the whole world,
mm.
you've devalued yourself. You've lost in that deal.
Mm.
And if you've lost your soul, the whole world cannot buy it back.
Oh my God, my God, my God.
Paula, you're on the air.
Yes, please, and good night to Choice Radio and
Amen.
Everyone. May God richly bless.
Hallelujah.
I'm calling for prayer for me and my family.
Amen. Amen. You and your family?
Yes.
Amen.
You know, I was serving the Lord, but somehow I went off and I want to get back my footing.
Yes. Hallelujah. Well, God is able. He's well able. Amen. And I know that he will give you the strength.
Yes.
And he will restore you. I want to tell you before we pray that God, amen.
Yes.
He doesn't condemn you. Amen.
Yes.
Because of whatever reason you have gotten weak and fallen away in whatever area.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He's right there with you. And he will bring you back even this moment.
Yes.
Amen. Father in heaven, we thank you for this
Hallelujah.
Caller. And we thank you, amen, yes. for using Choice Radio so someone
yes.
can
yes.
hear the words.
Hallelujah.
Thus said the Lord according to Jesus
yes.
Christ.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And calling for
yes,
prayer.
Lord
in heaven, we thank you for restoring your sister.
Yes, Lord.
Our
yes,
sister,
Lord.
Sorry. And her entire family
yes,
back
Lord,
to you.
Yes, Lord.
Because you said that you are married to the backslider.
Yes.
You said that you will never leave us nor forsake us. And whatever our consequences, we're not concerned with that. All we know is that the blood of Jesus Christ has washed her and is washing her even now.
Yes,
we apply
Lord,
the blood,
the blood,
amen,
the blood
to her entire
Jesus,
household, her body,
yes, Lord.
Everyone who is concerned with her,
yes,
even the extended family, those who have gotten weak
yes,
and fallen
Lord.
Away. True
yes,
doubt or whatever.
Yes, Lord.
Lord in heaven, we ask you to touch them right now by
yes,
your Holy Spirit.
Yes, yes.
Restore, Lord. Replenish. Lord, strengthen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Father in heaven, we bind them now with
yes,
cords that
yes,
cannot be broken.
Yes, Lord.
Even now, we come and we destroy the hand of the
yes,
enemy
yes.
against this saint. We destroy, hallelujah, everything that the devil has put up against her and her family. Everything that burden has bombarded her faith and weakened
yes,
her. Lord,
yes,
we speak right now and we destroy
yes,
it with the blood of the Lamb and with the
Jesus,
word of our testimony.
Yes,
the fire of the Holy Spirit that
yes,
we are more than overcomers
yes.
in Christ Jesus. Devil, we give you fair warning and we command you to take your hand off
of
this child of God. Take your hand off of that home, off of the members of that home. Oh, we destroy your plans and we declare that no
yes.
weapon that is formed against her can ever prosper. We destroy
yes.
every spoken word against her,
yes.
every idle conversation that is spoken
Jesus,
to even bring them down even more.
Yes.
We come against it with the name of Jesus
Hallelujah.
And we destroy it in the spirit. Lord in heaven, we break every chain. Hallelujah. Every hindrance,
yes.
every wall that has been put up against them
yes.
in the spirit. We go and hallelujah, we break it up. With
yes,
the blood
yes,
of the Lamb,
the blood of Jesus.
I go back even 10 generations.
Yes, Lord.
And every curse, hallelujah, that has been planted. Everything that has been, hallelujah, put in the ground, hallelujah.
Yes,
we root it up right now
in the
with
name
the blood of the Lamb.
Of
one, and we replace it, hallelujah,
yeah,
with the blessings of God, with the favor of God,
yes,
hallelujah, with the promise of God, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Father in heaven, we thank you,
for Lord,
delivering her,
thank you, Lord,
we thank you for delivering
thank
them,
you.
We cover that household once again
the
with
blood,
your blood,
the blood,
and
the
we
blood.
Put that protective hedge, we ask you to send your guardian angels,
yes,
even
Lord.
Right now,
yes.
And give her good sleep. Father in heaven, even if any sickness has beset them, hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, we destroy it right now.
Yes,
we apply Isaiah 53:4 to her body,
yes, Lord.
To her household,
yes,
to her
Lord.
Members,
yes,
hallelujah,
sir.
To the members of her family.
Yes,
Lord
sir.
In heaven, it says, by your stripes we were healed.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. And we destroy every symptom, every pain, every sickness.
Yes,
hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus,
every indication,
in
we root
the name
it out.
Of Jesus,
hallelujah. And we declare that you are whole and you are strong.
Yes, Lord.
In the name
yes,
of Jesus.
We
thank
you Lord.
For saving grace.
In
Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen and amen,
amen
and amen.
Hallelujah. Sister, be encouraged and be blessed. The Lord is with you. And the Holy Spirit is right there with you. I encourage you. Hallelujah. To continue. Amen. Hallelujah. If you haven't gone to church on Sunday, find somewhere to go and get into a little fellowship. Hallelujah. Even tomorrow, or if you could do it tonight, just give God a little praise.
Hallelujah.
Amen. For what he has done for you, because he has already done it in Jesus' name.
Yes. Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
So I like to read my Bible in the morning, but sometimes I don't know what to read.
Mm-hmm. Well, I encourage you to get into Romans 6 and 7.
It's a good start.
Okay. Start again with Romans 6 and 7.
That's it.
Okay.
Amen.
So Romans 6 in the morning.
Right. The Romans chapter 6 and chapter 7. Amen.
Yeah. Yes.
And remember, therefore now, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, for those who walk after the Spirit and not after the flesh.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Be blessed.
Okay. Thank you. God bless you too.
God bless you, sister.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, this is Choice Radio. We have a few more minutes and we invite you to call in for prayer. Amen. And we encourage the listeners out there who are listening to also send up some prayers for this saint and her family and household. Amen. Because when we join together, the Bible says that one will chase 1,000.
Hallelujah.
But two will put 10,000 to flight.
Yes.
So if there is 25 or 30 of us even tonight, say a prayer.
Amen.
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 Imagine what damage we will do against the kingdom of darkness.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we continue with God's evaluation of you.
Hallelujah.
Pardon. And we read Matthew 16 and 26.
Mm-hmm.
So we were saying that if a man loses soul and gain the whole world, he has gained nothing. And there is nothing, the whole world combined, cannot purchase one soul.
And we have over 7 billion.
7 billion.
Yes. Imagine.
And the whole world, all the wealth in the world, the whole world cannot purchase one of us.
You know, this brought me back to something that happened when our son was 2 years old.
Mm-hmm.
I was on my way going to netball practice and a man just walked up to me. Never saw him before in my life. And he said, "You have a son."
Mm-hmm.
And I said, "Excuse me." And he said, "If you sell his soul to me,"
mm-hmm,
"he say, I will give you riches."
Hmm.
And I remember I wasn't saved that time. I cursed that man so badly.
Mm-hmm.
He just ran off.
Mm-hmm.
And it's coming back to me now as we're talking about the soul.
Yes.
Because you see, God, he said, all souls are mine.
Amen.
But the enemy has been trying to take the souls.
Yes.
And could you imagine that I wasn't even conscious at that point what would have happened?
Amen.
So I would have been a rich person going to hell.
Hallelujah.
I would have had everything,
mm-hmm,
that I desire on this earth.
Mm-hmm.
But I wouldn't have been able to make it to eternity.
That's right.
So it's really, really a serious thing that no matter what Yes, we need to have money because the Bible says money answered all things.
Yes.
But money is not the principal thing.
Amen. I guess wisdom is.
Money is not the principal thing. Yes, we need money.
Mm-hmm.
And God will provide money as necessary as we go along.
Amen. Caller, you're on the air.
Hello, good night.
Good night.
I'm calling for prayer, please.
Amen. Hallelujah. You anything in particular? Or?
Yeah, my father just passed away like 3 hours ago. And I'm really stressed out.
Okay. Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Well, at death, no one is prepared.
Yes.
Amen. To deal with death. The strongest of saints, hallelujah, even cries over it. Amen. But what I can say in this time is God is even closer than before.
Amen.
Because a loss like this, hallelujah, I mean, I lost my mother over 10 years ago. Exactly 10 years ago. And sometimes when I'm alone, it comes to me and you know, I have to compose myself. So, you need strength. And
yes.
you need assurance that in everything, God must be, amen, glorified. Hallelujah. Are you saved?
No.
Amen. So, I'm telling you this now. I'm going to pray for you, but I want to tell you this, that now is a good time.
Amen.
Amen. To know that Jesus is the only Lord and Savior who is able to secure your soul forever.
Amen.
Amen. Father in heaven, we thank you for this sister.
Yes, Lord.
And we know that you have sent your Holy Spirit, who you said
Hallelujah.
Is the Comforter.
Yes, Lord.
Holy Spirit, we ask you to even right now envelop this dear sister in your arms.
Yes,
Hallelujah.
Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We petition your ministry
Hallelujah.
To go visit her home, wherever she is right
yes,
now,
Lord.
Listening
yes,
over the radio.
Hallelujah.
And just, Father in heaven, strengthen her heart, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Lord in heaven, we cannot do anything for the father that has passed.
Yes, Lord.
But we can do everything for her even now.
Amen, amen.
Lord in heaven, we ask you to give her understanding. Speak to her spirit. Speak to her mind and her heart. Lord in heaven, we ask you to touch her
yes.
by your holy power. Lord in heaven, bring clarity and understanding.
Yes, Lord.
Give her understanding about life and death. Amen. Lord in heaven, even though we join and we grieve with her.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
Father in heaven, because no death, hallelujah. Amen. No one who loses somebody is able to fully say, amen. I cannot worry about it, no matter how much years have passed. Lord in heaven, but because of Jesus Christ,
yes,
we are well able, amen, to be strengthened.
Amen.
Father in heaven, I ask you, amen, to apply your saving grace upon her.
Yes, Lord.
Even right now, we stretch forth our hands in the spirit.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
And we go to her, Lord Jesus.
Oh,
Father in heaven, we touch her and we join with her.
Yes,
amen.
Lord.
Father in heaven, we thank you for strengthening her.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you for keeping her. We apply your blood upon her household,
yes, Lord.
Upon the members of that family.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. And we ask you to give them peace.
Peace,
hallelujah.
Lord. Peace.
Peace tonight. Hallelujah. That
peace.
Passeth all understanding.
Yes, Lord.
Holy Spirit, we ask you to dwell with them even now.
Lord, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And bring them to the full understanding of who Jesus Christ is. Even in this, Lord,
yes.
you will be glorified.
Amen.
And we thank you
thank
for
you,
keeping
Lord.
And protecting, comforting,
thank you,
and strengthening
thank
this
you,
sister
Lord.
In peace.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name, amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Sister,
amen.
We thank you for calling in. And we know that the Holy Spirit, amen, is with you even now. His guardian
yes.
angels are with him. But we want you to take this time and seriously consider Jesus.
Yes.
Because he is the only answer to all your problems. He is the ultimate savior and the only one. Be blessed in Jesus' name.
Thank you very much.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Bye.
Hallelujah. Amen. We're sorry to hear that, but God is able still to do all things to
his
honor and glory.
Amen. Amen.
Through Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen. This is Choice Radio. It is your life and your salvation. It is your choice.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Have we have any more time?
We could go for 5 minutes again and then close off. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So we're gonna look at 1 Peter 2:9. 1 Peter 2:5-9. Hallelujah. We're dealing with God's evaluation of you. And as we said before, God doesn't look at the saint and look at the unbeliever and have a different value system. God values believer and unbeliever equally.
Amen.
They are all precious to him. The Bible plainly says that he sent his only begotten son to save the whole world.
Yes.
We were once out of the kingdom of heaven. We were once sinners walking according to our own will. But when Jesus came and we understood that because of Adam's sin, sin passed to all men. Amen. And that we realize if we didn't give our life to Jesus Christ, we would be eternally condemned.
Yes.
He was the only door
only
we can pass from death to life.
Amen. Amen.
And when we understood this, we hurriedly ran through that door.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Caller, you're on the air.
Hi, good evening. How are you?
Hallelujah.
Hi. Yeah, I'm listening to your program.
Amen.
All the time. I just ask you for prayer that God strengthen me, because I'm going through a lot. I don't know where they come from. They come from all angles. My landlord, my rent is like $910.
Uh-huh.
He sent me a lease, and and sent me a lease for $1,400 and something a month.
Mm.
And then here does not up yet. My lease going to be up on next year, and he said he's not taking away the preference right from me, and I'm paying the regular price. And it's very distressing for me because I'm not working a lot these days. It's very hard, very, very hard to pay $1,200 and something for one bedroom.
Amen.
I'm asking for strength in my back. It hurt me a lot of my legs, all of my lower part of my body.
Mm-hmm.
And I pray a lot. I go to church, but I work on weekend now, so I can't even go to church with me going to leave.
Mm-hmm.
I go to the church and ask them to help me with my rent.
Mm-hmm.
She's telling me, it's not to tell me that if she put it to the board, and the board only if you evicted, I didn't want it to come to that one. If it's evicted paper, it goes court. So I don't get that yet, so I don't know what's going to happen. I send them 2 months when they send it back.
Amen.
I'm just asking if I pray. I don't know what to do right now.
Hallelujah. Oh, Father in heaven, your word says that you shall supply all our needs according or our need according to your riches and glory. Lord in heaven, we come before you and we stand in the gap for this sister.
Yes, Lord.
And we agree with her, Lord,
yes,
Father in heaven.
Yes, yes.
You are able to do all things.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Even now, Lord, we, Father in heaven, ask you to, Lord in heaven, work out the situation for our dear
Lord,
sister.
Yes, Lord.
Lord in heaven, we ask you if it's to relocate her to a better apartment with a lower rent or a reasonable rent, Lord. Father in heaven, we ask you to send forth your hand, and this is an emergency call, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Father in heaven,
Lord,
we ask you, Lord Jesus, to stay the hand of the devourer.
Hallelujah.
Lord in heaven, even now, everything that is crooked, we ask you to straighten it in her life.
Yes, yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Father in heaven, we ask you to strengthen her body, Lord. Her body, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. We send forth your healing virtue by the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yes, yes.
Strengthen her body, Lord Jesus, so that she'll be able to, Lord in heaven, take care of herself. Lord in heaven, we come and we speak health and we speak strength into her body.
Upon that back. Yes.
Lord in heaven, we speak wholeness.
Yes, Lord, upon that back.
We come against pardon every pain.
Yes, Lord, in the name
hallelujah.
Of Jesus.
Every besetting ailment.
In the name of Jesus.
Every symptom, hallelujah.
In the name
that
of Jesus.
That suggests some sickness. We curse it right now from its root and we cause it to dry up in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Father, in him, we stand with the authority that you've given us as citizens of the kingdom of heaven.
Hallelujah.
And from our heavenly position in Christ
Lord,
Jesus,
yes, Lord.
We speak against this situation.
Yes, Lord.
And we break the hand of the enemy and the hold of the enemy upon her life.
Hallelujah.
Lord in heaven, and we declare and we decree without no doubt, hallelujah,
yes, Lord.
That you will take that landlord, Lord. Father in heaven, you said that the king's heart is in your hand.
Hallelujah.
Lord in heaven, we ask you to touch his heart right now,
right
Lord.
Right now, in Jesus
and let him have,
name.
Hallelujah, a second opinion. Change
yes,
his opinion.
Yes, change
for,
it, Lord.
For your child's sake, Lord.
We decree change.
We intercede
change.
On our behalf, Lord,
we
Father in heaven.
Change.
We stand and we intercede for him.
We
ask you to change his heart and let him change that lease, Lord. Let him lower that price, Lord, Father in heaven.
In the name of Jesus,
Lord in heaven, and we thank you for doing it.
Hallelujah, we thank you.
Father in heaven,
thank you. We, thank
we
you
bless
for
your holy name.
For victory.
And we declare and we decree,
it
even
so,
now that it is so.
So. It is so in
Jesus',
name.
Lord in
it
heaven,
so.
We ask you to set her free from all these obstacles, Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that she can be able to well serve and to send the praises to you with a free mind,
yes,
Lord, and with
yes,
a
Lord.
Heart of assurance, Lord.
Hallelujah.
That you is taking care of this situation. And you, Father in heaven, will show up in her life. Amen. You are Lord and Savior, and there is none like you.
Amen.
Sister, we ask you, hallelujah, to go in faith and believe that it is done. And God is glorified
hallelujah.
In your life. In amen. Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. You know, I'm sitting here and I'm led to sing What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And this song is you know, this is so it's different, but I'm just moving by. We're going to finish by 11:30. Amen.
Amen.
And I just want to do this song for our sister with the debt and this other sister who just called in. And all those of you who are listening and you need to be uplifted, know that you have a friend in Jesus tonight. Amen.
Hallelujah.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what things we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. Oh, because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Are your trials and temptation? Is there trouble anywhere? Jesus knows of every weakness. Oh, we will find our solace there. Adore your friends and them forsake thee. Just take it to Jesus in prayer. He will comfort, keep, and serve thee, and you will find your soul is there. So somebody, what a friend we have in, oh sweet Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. God loves you.
Hallelujah.
God has given you the highest value.
Hallelujah.
You might be listening out there, you haven't given your life to Jesus Christ. He doesn't love you even less than one who is already saved.
Amen.
He loves you the same.
Hallelujah.
For John 3:16 says that God so loved the world, amen, that he gave his only begotten son.
Yes.
That whosoever believeth on him, yes, believes on him shall be saved. All you got to do is believe that Jesus is the Son of God.
Amen.
And you shall be saved.
Amen, amen, amen.
It's not by works.
No.
Because our righteousness out of Jesus Christ, the Bible says, is like filthy rags.
Yes.
There is nothing that we can do or give to God to be saved. But all he requires is that you believe on Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that believing means that you believe that he is the Son of God.
Hallelujah.
That he is God incarnate. He came,
yes,
to save the world.
Amen.
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 He said that he came to save that which was lost.
Hallelujah.
Lost in what? Lost in sin. And he's the only remedy.
Amen.
His saving and his salvation, amen, is a final and a complete job.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus is the only way.
Amen.
This is Choice Radio.
Amen.
It is your life, it is your salvation, and it is your choice. God has put your value at an infinite value, meaning it cannot be calculated.
Hallelujah.
One soul is worth more than the whole world.
Yes.
You have infinite value. Your value cannot be assessed.
Oh, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
There is nothing in the world that compares to you or what you're worth to God. Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 We have about 7 more minutes and we invite you to call in. Amen. If you want prayer or to discuss the matter at hand, God's evaluation of you. We will look at 1 Peter 2:5-9. Amen.
5 and 9.
Yes.
Okay, 1 Peter 2:5. You say, ye also, as lively stones,
mm-hmm,
are built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood,
uh-huh,
to offer up spiritual sacrifices,
amen,
acceptable to God by Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
And 9 says, but ye are a chosen generation,
uh-huh,
a royal priesthood,
yes,
a holy nation,
uh-huh,
a peculiar people,
yes,
that you should show forth the praises of him,
amen,
who has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Okay, and the final scripture, I want you to tie this to 1 Corinthians 6:19,
and uh-huh, it reads, what?
Uh-huh.
Know ye not that your body is a temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you,
uh-huh,
which you have of God?
Hallelujah.
And you are not your own?
You are not your own.
You are not your own.
Now listen, in 1 Peter 2:5,
mm-hmm,
he plainly speaks about, amen, we being built up a holy temple.
Yes.
Holy stones.
Yes.
Amen. To offer praises unto God.
Amen.
In 1 Corinthians now, he says that the Holy Spirit, know ye not that your body,
mm-hmm,
is the temple.
Yes.
The same temple that Peter says that is being built up.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Now Paul in 1 Corinthians says that, don't you know that your body is a temple, a holy temple?
Mm-hmm.
But in this temple dwells the Holy Spirit. We are so valuable that God decided, amen, to put his Holy Spirit mm-hmm. in us.
Amen.
Because now we are holy temples.
Yes.
You cannot get more valuable than that.
Mm.
For you to have and be walking around with the Holy Spirit, God Himself in you,
mm-hmm.
it speaks of your exponential value,
Amen.
Eternal infinite value,
Amen.
That we have. We do not understand
mm-hmm.
fully. Even though I'm telling you, I do not understand fully.
Mm-hmm.
I have a small comprehension,
mm-hmm.
and it is growing the more I grow in the Word.
Amen.
Of my value,
yes,
to Jesus Christ, because
yes.
it says that we know not, amen.
Yes, we know not
what we will be,
mm-hmm.
but when He
shall appear,
mm-hmm. we shall see Him face to face,
mm-hmm.
and the Holy Spirit, amen, from glory to glory is transforming us. Amen. Mm. Into the very image of Christ.
Mm.
My God.
Amen.
God's evaluation of you tonight. What do you think of yourself? Sinner and saint, I'm speaking to you. Who do you think you are? Are you a mere man? No. You're God's creation. You belong to God. Amen. And God has said that the whole world is nothing, has no value compared to you only. It has no value compared to you. This is Choice Radio. I am Reverend Dr. Jimmy Baptiste, and with my wife, Reverend Dr. Sandra Baptiste, and we stop by here tonight because, you know, I feel something happening in the spirit.
Amen, amen, amen.
I feel some chains being broken.
Hallelujah.
I feel some breakthroughs, some people are loosed. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Because the greatest thing to know is to know your value.
Amen, amen, amen.
Everybody wants to be appreciated in life.
Amen.
But the greatest thing to know is to know the Creator, how He sees you.
Amen, amen, amen.
When you understand the value that the Creator has put on you,
mm-hmm.
then the limits that man tries to put on you automatically is destroyed.
Amen. In the name of
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Come on, speak
Father,
to the people.
Father. We listen to me. I said before that the devil is afraid of you.
Uh-huh.
He's afraid of the saints who know.
Amen.
That they know.
Hallelujah.
He's running scared even right now because the information is coming out.
Yes.
The Bible says that the people perish for lack of knowledge.
Lack of knowledge.
For so long you've been going around thinking that you ain't nothing. For so long you've been going around thinking, well, I ain't a pastor, and I'm not the bishop, and I'm not the doctor, and I'm not this, and I'm not that. But tonight, tonight you have heard that you're valuable to God.
Infinite value.
Tonight you have heard that the heaven is your limit.
Yes.
Tonight you have heard that you're above and not beneath.
Yes.
Tonight you have heard that you're not just made in the image. Hallelujah. But the likeness of God is manifesting in your life. Tonight, glory to God, you have heard that you will trample upon serpents.
Uh-huh.
Tonight you will hear and you will know that you will rejoice because your name is written in the Lamb's book of life. Tonight, glory to God, you're gonna wake up in the morning knowing that no weapon formed against you prosper, and every tongue that rises up against you, it is condemned, because it is the heritage of those who love the Lord.
Yes.
Tonight you would have learned that weeping, glory to God,
may
endure for a night.
Hallelujah.
I'm here to tell my sister tonight that your weeping has come.
Hallelujah.
But your dawn is about to break forth.
Yes.
Because you're going to know Jesus. You're going to confess Him.
Yes.
And you're going to serve Him. I decree it tonight.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus, that your morning time
is
about to come.
Your day has
Hallelujah.
Come.
So Lord, we just thank you tonight.
Thank you
that Choice Radio is about to reach to heights that it has never reached before.
Yes, Lord.
We declare tonight, because Jesus is the CEO of Choice Radio,
Hallelujah,
that the man of God and the woman of God that He has put to bring a directive for Choice Radio to come forth,
yes,
Lord, that you will bring them to glory to glory.
Hallelujah.
That the glory of God is about to be revealed in them like never before.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we declare tonight that Minister Strachan's Evangelist Katie.
Amen.
Lord, we declare it tonight.
Hallelujah.
That fire will come out of their mouth.
Hey.
That they will decree things that is going to come to pass. In the name of Jesus. That healings will take place through their mouths.
Yes, Lord.
In this radio station.
Thank you.
We declare it tonight. That blind eyes will be opened through this radio station.
Manifest glory.
That mouths that are dumb will speak.
Yes, Lord.
That deliverance of drugs will come forth and leave.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we thank you tonight.
Hey.
We glorify you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We magnify you.
Hey.
We lift you up. And we say to God be the glory.
Hallelujah.
Great things he has done and will continue to do in Jesus' name.
Amen. Hallelujah. This is Choice Radio. Be blessed. Hallelujah. The Redeemer lives.
Where to stand in the morning and too tall the ocean, it could only come this far, and to show the moon where to hide till evening, whose words alone can catch the falling stars.